my pranams to all Atma Jyotis, divine light of the self. Continuing our talk on Atmavichara, inquiry into nature of self, today I will take up what we call as Avastha Traya Viveka or analysis of three states of consciousness. The Vedantic teaching doesn't require you to believe in something and accept. Vedantic teaching is founded on basis of our day-to-day experience. We can always relate to day-to-day experience, Vedantic teachings. If you are not able to relate to day-to-day experience, then teaching or understanding the teaching becomes impossible. Vedanta focuses on the teaching based on our day-to-day experience only. Nothing special. But there is something special about Vedanta. Our day-to-day experience is available to our knowledge. Day-to-day experience, we experience the world in waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. That's the subject of our knowledge, or we understand it, knowledge. There are some things in life we can know, what I call as knowable. And there is something in life which is not knowable. Right? There are two categories, knowable and not knowable. For example, I can find out what is there in, what movies are going in Bangalore, probably knowable. But if I were to find out what movie is going on in some village in Africa, I cannot know it. There is no easy way of knowing it. It is not knowable. There is a category of knowable and not knowable, right? Then, in this knowable and knowable, I put it as known and unknown. But not knowable, I can with some difficulty, I may be able to know it also. Unknown can become known also, right? Not knowable has a category where with some difficulty I can know it. Whereas there is a category which is impossible to know, which is unknowable, whatever you do. So in other words, there is knowable, that's not known but knowable, but it's unknowable. There are three categories, right? The focus of Vedanta is about unknowable. Whatever you do, you cannot know. Unknowable from our, by our mind. Unknowable for our intellect. Unknowable for from any faculty which we have. Unknowable means impossible to know. And that unknowable is the X factor, and that unknowable is called Brahman or Supreme Reality. No matter what you do, you cannot know it. Unknowable by any means. Then it's a hopeless situation. Knowable, knowable with difficulty, we can do something about it. But something which is unknowable, we cannot do anything. No matter what we do, we cannot know about it. But then Vedanta also promises, if you know the unknowable, that's a paradox, then you will attain the supreme. If you know that unknowable Brahman, you will attain supreme bliss, liberation. So, knowable, unknown but knowable difficulty, and unknowable is Brahman. But there's a motivation to know about Brahman, because if you know about Brahman, if you know Brahman, you'll become free. So this is a paradox. Unknowable, it can be known. Okay. So now here the qualification, known, we have to qualify. In any knowledge, there's a subject and an object. If there's a flower, the flower is the object, and I know the flower, there's a subject. There's a subject and object relationship in any kind of knowledge. So the subject-object relationship is applicable to knowable and not known but knowable situations. So Brahman doesn't come in the category of subject-object. Brahman doesn't come in the category of subject and object. Brahman is beyond subject and object. Then is there a possibility of knowing Brahman? Yes, not as an object, not as a subject, but as our own self, Atman. Brahman is known as our own self, Atman. But it's not a subject-object knowledge, it is not an experience, but it is what we are. So then there is a question, if there is Brahman what I am, myself is Brahman, how come I don't know about it? How do I know, how come I don't know about myself? I know about myself more than anybody knows. How can Upanishad or Vedanta teach me about myself, which I know about myself? That is true. Vedanta or Upanishad cannot teach you about yourself. Vedanta or Upanishad cannot teach you about yourself, but they can help to remove ignorance of yourself, the wrong understanding of yourself, so that right understanding shines. The Vedantic teaching is to remove the wrong understanding one have about ourselves, so that we recognize our own nature as Brahman. The whole focus of Vedanta is to remove the wrong understanding we have about ourselves. Once the wrong understanding is removed, the right understanding or right knowledge of the self shines by itself. So the approach of Vedanta is a removal of ignorance. And this removal of ignorance is called self-knowledge. Now, self-knowledge is not a degree to be acquired. I did my master's, I did a PhD, so I studied some 5 scriptures or 10 scriptures. So it's not about self-knowledge, it's not about acquiring something. Self-knowledge is more and more progressively removing or dropping what I know wrongly. It is about dropping rather than gaining. What is that we have to drop? I have an understanding that I am the body, I am the intellect, I am the mind. Whenever I deal with somebody, I am the body, feeling comes. Okay? I am tall, I am handsome, I am man, I am woman. So these are the qualifications which I have, which I consider as myself. There are other qualifications also. I am a graduate, I am a housewife, I am a doctor. My professional qualifications also add to myself. I am a rich man, poor man. We add so many qualifications to our selves. And we start living as if this is a reality. I am the body. I am an engineer. I am a tall, handsome. I am a young man. So these become our so-called perceived reality. Or rather, we accept this perceived reality as our own reality. What is the problem with this? Any of these qualifications, what we call our my own qualification or me, the profession, sooner or later the profession, you have to get retired from profession, so no longer you are in the same profession. It becomes a past profession. The body gets aged and the body dies. Man or woman, whoever you are, one day will be, after you leave the body will be thrown into the fire. Everything what I call myself keeps changing constantly. And that creates an unsettling effect on me, because constantly I am trying to look for security. Even though not knowing, I don't know what security is, that deep inside I start feeling insecure, because whatever I know myself will keep on changing. So then I do something in life and I become happy, so I am happy. Next moment I am sad, so I am happy, I am sad. Then I am worried, I don't know what's going on. So these are the qualifications we add to myself. Whatever I call as myself gets bloated into many things in the world, or a psychological conditioning called happiness and unhappiness, or intellectual conditioning called thinking, knowledge. And all of these are temporary and go. So this starts unsettling us. Reality, which is myself, which is beyond this changing qualification, and that reality is called Atma, or the self, which is nothing but absolute reality called Brahman. So Vedanta teaches us the reality itself has three categories of reality. There is a three category of reality. To tell you this three category, or you heard one story which is often you have heard, I'll repeat the story. There was a lion cub which died, the mother died, and the lion cub was taken by a shepherd. The lion cub started growing along with the sheep, and lion cub thought, I am a sheep, and started living like a sheep. It grew up, but because of the environment, it thinks he is a sheep. Then one day one lion comes and tells this so-called sheep that you are not a sheep, you are a lion. Okay, come, I'll show you. And takes that sheep, the so-called sheep, to a pond and shows its face. See, you are lion now, you are a lion, you're not a sheep. Now this so-called sheep recognizes lion nature and starts roaring. This story you've heard many times. So this story I'm telling here only for a purpose of illustration of three levels of reality which you have not heard in this story. The first, the lion cub was always a lion. Lion cub never became a sheep, right? Lion cub was always a lion and it never became a sheep. Before he met the other lion, it was still a lion cub. It was a lion. And after meeting also, it's lion. So that means lionness, so-called lionness, has not changed at all. Right? This unchanging reality is called absolute reality. I mean, I'm just giving an example, okay? Not exactly same. I'm giving an analogy to absolute reality. It's called absolute reality or paramarthika satya, which never changes. The absolute reality never changes at any point of time. The lionness of the lion cub never changed. It started behaving like a sheep, but it never changed the lionness. After recognizing that I am not a sheep, still the lionness is same. Before also it was same. There's no fundamental change in the lionness. So there is something in us which never changes. That is the fundamental reality of us, which never changes. And that fundamental reality is called paramarthik satya. It's called absolute reality. Like a lionness of a lion, the fundamental reality of each of us has never changed, has never changed. Whether you are ignorance, you are realized, it doesn't matter. That fundamental reality never changes. And that fundamental reality for all of us is called Brahman. And that is myself. The unchanging reality. Like a lioness of a lion cub, lioness of a sheep, so-called sheep, lioness of a lion, which never changed. The absolute the reality of a man, the reality of a woman, reality of me, which never changes, is called Brahman. Now, what is that reality? We'll find out. Right? So, in between, the lion cub started living another reality, which is that sheep. Okay? It last started living a sheep. Even though lion is a lion, it started living like a sheep. Now, where is the sheep? Sheepness. The lionness is fundamental reality. Where is the sheepness in lion cub?
Belief.
Sheepness in the lion cub in the mind of the cub. Sheepness in the lion cub is in the mind of the lion cub. So it is not a reality as such. So the sheepness is the mental reality. It's not the absolute reality, which is lionness. This mental reality, which has nothing to do with the reality, it is not a sheep definitely, right? Is called Pratibhasika Satya or Illusory Reality. Illusion. Okay? It is not real in the absolute sense. There is no basis. Nobody has come and told you are a sheep. A mental concept that I am a sheep is there. That's called illusory reality or Pratibhasika Satya. Pratibhasika means reflection. Reflected in the mind of that animal. Okay. Coming back to human beings, we also live in a reflected or illusory reality. What is that? I am a body. Okay? The body doesn't tell you that I am you. Somehow I assume that body is me. Somehow I assume that mind is myself. Somehow I assume that intellect is myself. We take it for granted, like lion cub has taken I am a sheep as for granted. We take ourselves as I am a human being for granted. The Vedanta questions this assumption of yours and tries to point out to you, you are something more than a human being. In fact, you are not a human being, you are the absolute reality. Like sheep, so-called sheep is not a sheep, but a lion itself. Our understanding of ourselves is based on the assumption which we have built over a period of time. Our own assumptions. There is no basis that I am a body, no basis that I am mind, no basis that I am intellect. On deeper questioning, these assumptions will fall off. That is the approach of Vedanta. So then there is a transactional reality. One is the absolute reality. So that's called Paramarthika Satya, which never changes. Then Pratibhasika Satya or illusory reality. Of course, illusory reality is another category also. We people get delusioned. They start seeing something which people, other people cannot see. Okay? They get into more delusions. These are more psychological disturbances. But normally most of the people believe that they are a body, mind and intellect without any questioning the belief system. And beyond that, there is another level of reality, is called Vyavaharika or transactional reality or empirical reality. I do the transaction, I interact with you. Okay? I interact with you, I do the transaction. We meet people, we carry out our household activities or business or office. So now this is not in my mind. This place where we are sitting, okay, is a shared reality. It's a collective reality. There is something which is only confined to my mind and something is a shared reality where transactions happen. That's called transactional reality or empirical reality. It's called Vyavaharika Satya. So there are recognition of three levels of reality. Absolute reality, then illusory reality. Absolute reality is called Paramarthika Satya. Illusory reality is called Pratibhasika Satya. And transactional reality is called Vyavaharika Satya. Now what is the transactional reality of this so-called sheep? So it is eating with other sheep. It's grazing the grain, grazing the grass. It's a transaction, it's day-to-day transactions like a sheep. Okay? Absolute reality of the lion cub is lion, lionness. The illusory reality of lion cub is sheepishness. Okay? The transaction reality of the lion cub is behavior like a sheep. So, is these three levels of reality understood? Absolute, illusory, and transactional. Paramarthika, Vyavaharika, and Pratibhasika, and Vyavaharika. Pratibhasika is only for your mind. Okay? Within your mind. Vyavaharika is a collected shared reality. This room, the sun, moon, all these things is not just in my mind. It's a collective mind. Where it's available for transaction. If something is in my mind only, this transaction is not possible. So this I am the body comes in the category of transactional reality also, because I am the body is useful for me to do the transaction. Okay? But I have some notions of myself, which is my private ideas, which is not available for transaction. Okay? So that's called Pratibhasika Satya. So the Vedantic teaching is to, for all of us to understand that absolute reality is myself. Just like lion cub was taught, that you are not a sheep, but you are a lion. Like that, the Vedanta teaches us, you are not a man or a woman. You are not the mind, the mental conditions do not disturb you. You are not the intellect, a thinker or knower. Absolute reality of you, which is Paramarthika Satya, is awareness. Pradnana is your absolute reality. Pradnanam Brahma. So that is your absolute reality. Now, without knowing your absolute reality, you are living as if you are a human being, subject to birth and death, subject to miseries of life, like a lion cub is living like a sheep. Now, what happened to the lion cub? What happened to the so-called sheep when it came to know that I am a lion? Did it any fundamental change happen? Lioness changed? Did sheepness change? The sheepness of that sheep, the so-called sheep, did it change? Or lioness changed? So then what is the benefit of that? What is the benefit which the lion cub got by knowing that she is not a sheep but a lion? Is there a benefit? Huh? By knowing the true nature, what happened to the so-called sheep?
Started living like a lion.
The so-called sheep was always afraid of a lion. The fear. Only the fear disappeared and no fundamental change happened in the nature, which is lioness. So similarly, by knowing Brahman, knowing that I am Brahman or I am pure awareness, no fundamental change happens in any of us. Don't be under the impression that at the moment I know Brahman, I'll have a superior X-ray vision, or I touch something, something will happen. No such thing will happen. Don't be under the delusion that some miracles will happen, some magic will happen. Nothing that life will happen. Okay? What will happen is, the so-called deep-rooted fear in us, the fear of uncertainty, fear of change, fear of constant turmoil which is happening, which is affecting us, that fear will drop. And we experience a deep peace which is beyond all, it's called Parashanti, which is beyond any type of peace you have experienced in the world. The absolute peace and the fearlessness appears in us. So that fearlessness, that absolute peace is called, also called Ananda. Ananda means infinity, bliss. It's called by various names, but this is the only purpose of knowing that I am Brahman. Your day-to-day activity will continue to be same. Okay, you're going to the office or doing some work will be same, but a clarity will emerge. This is my real nature, and because of that, the fearlessness and peace will be our character, our essential nature. We regain what we forgot. Now, how this is done? It is done by an elimination process. Okay, that elimination process is called neti, neti, neti. Not this, not this, not this. What you are not, you are trying to eliminate. What you are not, you are trying to say not this. Okay, it is not a positive means. It's not a positive process. Hey, you are Brahman. Okay, your Brahman teaching is there, but only to point out to you. But the entire method of Vedanta is based on a negation process. Okay? Why it is a negation process? Because Brahman is never an object of knowledge. All ob- objects of knowledge has to be negated, eliminated to go back to the self. So this method of negation is called neti 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 marga, or not this, not this, not this. What is not this, what is not this, not is not this? Nanu nanembudu nanalla ideha manabuddhi nanalla sachidanandatma shivananunani shivoham shivoham shivoham. The method of Vedanta is to say, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not intellect, I am the awareness which is giving life to this body, mind and intellect. Okay, it's a process of elimination. So you can think it's like more like a digging a well. Okay, when you dig a well, you are not creating water, water is already there deep inside. You are eliminating, you are taking mud and throwing it out, taking mud and throwing it out. Similarly, Vedanta, method of Vedanta is taking the ignorance and throwing it out. Take the ignorance and throw it out. Okay? After you, once you start digging the well, the water is already there. You find water. So as you stop, as you throw out the ignorance, you discover your own nature. Like you discover water, and that nature of the self is the absolute reality, Brahman, which cannot be further negated. It's not water, is not mud. So once you remove the ignorance, what remains is the pure knowledge or absolute knowledge, is called Brahman, which cannot be further negated. So that is the process of Vedanta, negation. Not this, it's not a positive method. Okay, so this also Vedanta here teaches based on what you know. Vedanta takes you from known to unknowable. Okay, known is I am a body, I am a mind, I am a husband, I am a wife, I am so and so. All this is known. From known, Vedanta takes you to unknowable, which is your nature. So that's the beauty of Vedanta. And there is no force here. Believe this, there is no force. It is simply based on your day-to-day experience it takes. So that method of teaching of Vedanta is called a prakriya or a process. A process of teaching. So one of the prakriyas of Vedanta is called avastha traya prakriya, means three states of consciousness, waking, dreaming, deep sleep state is taken. Waking, dreaming, deep sleep is what I know every day. It's known. From the known, I will have to go to unknown or unknowable. Okay? So the jump has to be made from known to unknowable. So that's the teaching. Now let us look at our waking, dreaming and deep sleep state. Okay, every day every day we go through three states: waking, dreaming and deep sleep. Right, so for a moment we'll call these three people as the waking state person as Miss Jagrati. Waking state person is called Miss Jagrati. Person is who is in a waking state. Okay. The dreaming person, the same person start dreaming. And for the person who is dreaming, I'll call her as Miss Swapna. Dreaming person as Miss Swapna. And deep sleep person, we call her as Miss Sushupti. Okay, so we have three persons: Miss Jagrati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. Have you met these three persons in your life? Every day. Waking, dreaming, deep sleep. Waking, dreaming, deep sleep. It goes on and on. Waking, dreaming, deep sleep. Jagrata, sapna, sushupti. Jagrata, sushupti. Our whole life is a cycle. Waking, dreaming, deep sleep. It goes in this circle every day. So these are very familiar characteristics for us, right? Miss Jagrati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. Now here comes the fun. So this waking state, Miss Jagrati, is living in a world which is some fantastic world called Bangalore. Attends a lot of satsangs. And Miss Dreaming, Miss Swapna, she is completely different personality. She has a different body. Okay, she is living in a different world. Is it true or not? In a dream, you have a different body, different world, and live in different places. What about Miss Sushupti? What? Nothing is known. There is no world, no body, nothing is there. So are these three different persons or only one person? Okay. How do you say it's one person? Because Miss Jagrati has never met Miss Sushupti. When Miss Jagrati is there, Miss Sushupti never comes. When Miss Sushupti is there, Miss Jagrati never comes. And when both are not there, Miss Jagrati has never met Miss Swapna. Miss Swapna has never met Sushupti. Miss Sushupti has not met these two people. They are mutually exclusive and all of them live in three different worlds altogether. Do you agree or disagree? Miss Jagrati's world is very different from Miss Swapna's world. Miss Sushupti's world is no world. So they are living in different worlds at all. Different worlds. Do you agree or disagree? And they live in different time frames also. So Miss Jagrati spends lot of time working morning to evening, working hard, earning money or taking care of household. 8 or 10 hours or 12 hours a day. Miss Swapna, very quickly she has taken a young body, she has grown up, she is married, she has kids, she has a family, and of course she goes to Paris, London and all, enjoys life. Whereas Miss Jagrati is struggling to earn her money. So Miss Swapna is enjoying life. And her time frame is very different. So she's her whole lifetime she may be spending, and Miss Jagrati says within 2 minutes the dream I went through whole lifetime. So that means there are different time scales also. They are not living in the same time scale, time frame.
Can we compare to actor who is doing three different roles?
We can compare, but there are not only three different roles. There is three different bodies, three different places, and three different time frames also. The time frame of sleep, dream is completely different from the waking state. This is an actor only, definitely. But what I'm saying is I'm pointing out that time is different, the space is different, the body is different, entirely different. There's no relationship at all. Of course, there's some memories will be there. Otherwise, they are completely time, space, body, the family, everything is different. So, are you getting what I'm saying? Miss Swapna lives in a different time scale. She may go through entire life, or sometimes Miss Swapna can fly in the sky also. Right? Superwoman. Miss Sushupti or deep sleep doesn't know what is time at all. Miss Sushupti doesn't know what is space at all. Doesn't know your world. Bangalore is not known. Body is not known. She is living in timeless, spaceless, bodiless, mindless reality. So can you see that these three are very, very different personalities? Yes or no? So do we have a split personality? Three split personalities. Waking, Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti, three split personalities. Is it same me? But the same me forgets everything in a dream state. It's completely new world. In deep sleep, it's completely gone. So another fun. In Miss Swapna got a lottery ticket. Okay? She got a money in lottery ticket. She got 10 crores in a lottery ticket, bumper prize. And she woke up from the dream. She says, I got a lottery ticket, 10 crores. Huh? She laughs. Okay? Why she laughs? The 10 crore, what is the point of, what is the 10 crore, what happened to that? The 10 crore is not real. Right? It is false. So is Miss Swapna real from the Miss Jagati point of view? Is Miss Swapna real from Miss Jagati point of view?
No.
Miss Swapna doesn't exist as a dream character, disappeared. So Miss Jagati says Miss Swapna is not real. Do you agree? Anybody says dream character is real for real you? Yes or no? So Miss Jagati says Miss Swapna is unreal. Okay? Why she is unreal? She doesn't exist when you wake up. Miss Jagati says Miss Swapna is unreal because when I wake up, she is not there. I've never seen her. Now let us ask Miss Swapna. Oh my dear Miss Swapna, is Miss Jagrati real? What does Miss Swapna say when I put Jagrati? Miss Swapna, what does she say about Miss Jagrati?
She doesn't exist.
Miss Jagrati, I don't know what she is, who she is. Okay? Who do you think I am? I am Miss Jagrati. That's why, see, I am enjoying. So Swapna says the characteristic of the Jagrati and says she is the Jagrati and she denies that somebody else is called Jagrati is there. Do you agree or disagree? The Swapna character will deny the real character and says I am that character. Right? When you are going to Paris, you have never gone to Paris in waking state. In dream state you are comfortable going to Paris as if you are that character. And you deny any other character other than you. Agree or disagree? Miss Sushupti doesn't know any of this. She denies there is a Miss Jagrati or Miss Swapna or Miss Sushupti and world also.
Nobody.
Right? So, in a single day of 24 hours, we are going through three different worlds. We are going through three different bodies, if not more. We are going through three different time zones. Okay? And we are going through three different personalities, each of whom are denying the other two personalities. Miss Jagrati denies Miss Swapna and Miss Sushupti. Miss Swapna denies Miss Jagrati and Miss Sushupti. Miss Sushupti denies both Miss Jagrati and Miss Swapna. Out of these, whom do you believe? These three characters, who is telling the truth?
Nobody.
But we are very confident I am this body. So, these three characters are nobody is telling the truth. Miss Jagrati is not telling the truth because they are denying the other two. Right? You are denying, see, please understand, are these three your own experience? Your own experience, can you deny one part of your own experience? If you deny one part of your own experience, that means that experience is not real. As Miss Jagrati, you are denying Miss Swapna. That means you are denying your own experience called Miss Swapna. And Sushupti denying Miss Jagriti and Miss Swapna. That means you are denying your own experience in other two states. Is nobody else is coming, okay? You are denying your own states. Anybody has any other opinion about this? Huh? So you are denying your own experience of other two states. But are you sure that these three belongs to you? These three are you? So which of these is real you? Miss Jagriti, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti, which of these is real you?
Jagriti.
You feel?
Jagriti.
Miss Jagriti is real.
Because in the Jagriti we are able to define everything, understand everything.
Okay. So he says Miss Jagriti is real. How many people believe that Miss Jagriti is real? Can you please raise your hand? You are in minorities.
No, I'm coming to that.
I'm just trying to. Yeah. I'll come to that, right? So he says Miss Jagriti is real. Okay, let's take a voting, okay? How many people believe that Miss Jagriti is real me? Can you please raise your hand? Nobody.
Confused.
Huh? Sorry?
Confused.
Confused. Okay, Miss Swapna is real me. Miss Sushupti is real me. Okay, there are two people who is Miss Sushupti is me. Okay, we'll go to Jagriti. Okay, one person voting for Jagriti, nobody for Miss Swapna, and two people for Mr. Sushupti. Okay? Other people what?
Confused.
Alright? So, sir, you are like you, there was a Zen master. You have a beard, he had a slightly bigger beard. Okay? One day, Zen master woke up and he started crying. He started crying. The students, Zen master, a lot of students, all students gathered around the master. Okay? Sir, what happened? Right? I had a dream. In the dream, I became a butterfly. What happened to in the dream? I became a butterfly. Then all the students started laughing. Sir, it was a dream. Why bother about it? Right? The Zen master started crying more. Started crying. Sir, why are you crying now? I don't know whether Zen master became a butterfly in the dream or butterfly became a Zen master in the dream. Which is true? You understood the problem? Have you understood or not? In any point of time, we cannot separate out what is real and what is dream. Because in dream, when we experience it, we feel it's real. In dream also you have knowledge. In dream also you study engineering. In dream also you get married. And that time it appears real.
But still that reality, whatever
you feel,
dream state,
it should be material in the dark state. No, that's what I'm saying. That what you call has a dream state. You'll never be able to distinguish what is a dream and what is real. Because when you're dreaming, it appears as real. For example, let me ask, put a question. I mean, just hypothetical, okay? Not real. I am saying, at this point of time, you are sleeping in your bed and dreaming that you are in the satsang. When you are dreaming, it appears real. When we dream something, the dream appears real. Do you agree or disagree? In dream we can study medical or engineering, it appears real. We cannot find out it is a dream in that time. So now at this moment, I am hypothetically, okay, not really. All of you are sleeping at home and dreaming that you are attending satsang. Is there a way for you to find out if it's a dream or reality? Is there a way for any of us to find out what is dream and what is reality at any point of time? When you wake up, you'll know as a dream, okay? But in dream also, you can wake up and think that you've woken up in the dream. No. Dream, I was sleeping in the bed. In the dream, I woke up and I went to Paris. See, what I'm trying to say, point out is, the dream experience also appears to be real when you are experiencing it. Alright? Are you getting what I'm saying? The dream, if you're in a dreamy Paris, oh, you know, never say it's a dream Paris, it's real. In dream, if you are flying, oh, I'm really flying, you'll say. So you'll never question it is a dream in the dream state. That means, my dear sir, there's no way you can find out what the difference between a dream and real state at any point of time. No, no. When you are dreaming, let's say you are in a dream now. Okay? In the dream, everything appears real. Let's say in dream, you go to Paris. Does Paris appear real?
In dream, you are
dreaming.
It's not real.
No, no, no. When you wake up, you say it's not real. But in dream, in your dream, you are in Paris. While dreaming. Let us say, in your dream, a tiger came. Will you run or not? In your dream, not because waking up. In the dream state. While you are dreaming, a tiger came. So what did you do? Oh no, no, it's a dream tiger, I won't run, you will say. Dream tiger appears real at that time. That's what I mean. Don't mix up the situation. I'm saying when you are dreaming, the dream appears real. Yes or no? After waking up, you say not real. But before waking up,
your heart beats also comes.
Yeah, your heart beat will happen, your palpitation will happen, everything will happen. Don't mix up the situation. When you are dreaming, is dream tiger real or false? Right? You'll run. Tiger comes. Whatever you experience in the dream, is it appears to be real or not?
Appears, really appears.
No, no, no. Don't speak from the waking point of view. I'm speaking from the dream point of view. No, no, no. I'm saying you don't take your own dream. In your dream, you encountered a tiger. Will you run or will you not run? You will not run? You run, because dream tiger is real at that point. After waking up, you say dream tiger, way after waking up. Are you getting what I mean? So, waking up, you can comment on the dream. Say dream tiger. But while dreaming, it is real, no? Is everybody getting it or not? When you are dreaming, everything appears to be real. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, everything is appearing as real. Either dream or reality. The other question. While dreaming, everything appears real. Okay? While dreaming, everything appears real. Now we are, everything is appearing as real. Is it dream or reality? Please tell me.
What you are seeing, is it reality or a dream?
So, our old ancestor said, at any point of time, the quality of a dream and quality of waking experience is same. The quality. Ancestor said, the dreaming quality, please understand, dreaming experience quality, I'm not speaking of the what you experience quality in dreaming state, and waking state experience quality, they are one and the same. When you are dreaming, it appears real. In your dream, you are made your husband, you say, no, this is dream husband, no, you'll not say, you'll tap him. The dream tiger will not run away. In waking state, you are meeting husband and say it's real. So now, which is dream and which is real? ಡ್ರೀಮರ್ ಮೈ ಚಿಗಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲ ಮೈ ಪಿಂಚ್ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇನ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಯು ಪಿಂಚ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಯುಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೊ ಅವರ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಝೆನ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಓ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ವೆದರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಝೆನ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಟರ್ಫ್ಲೈ ಆರ್ ಬಟರ್ಫ್ಲೈ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಝೆನ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಮಿಸ್ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಜಾಗೃತಿ ರೈಟ್ ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ನೋ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಜಾಗೃತಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಎಟ್ ಎನಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದಟ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡ್ರೀಮಿಂಗ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಯಾ ದ ಮಾಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಡ್ರೀಮ್ you will know this is a dream only when you wake up for from yesterday night's dream when you woke up you said it's a dream but till that point it's real unless you wake up from the dream you will never know it is real you will know the reality of the dream only when you wake up right isn't it so do you understand the quality of the dream experience and quality of waking experience is same quality both appear to be real when you are experiencing is that clear to everybody and no point of time anybody in the history of any time will know what is dream and what is reality because experience quality is same yeah. that's why
you said you think the real existence
is not real yeah it is called it's a sort of dream like structure and that dream like structure is called maya sort of But this is dream-like structure only when you know, when you wake up from this dream. And this waking from this dream is called mukti or enlightenment. Waking up from the dream-like waking state. Okay? If you wake up from this dream, then you are mukta, jivan mukta, or liberated, or brahmatnari. Understand?
Yes.
The waking up from this waking dream. Now let me give you one more thing. Miss Jagrati and Miss Swapna, they have a fight. Miss Jagrati says Miss Swapna is false. Okay? Miss Swapna says Miss Jagrati is false. Now, both are you only. Which one you believe? Because both qualities are same. Are getting your getting problem of this thing? See, these are day-to-day experiences. Nothing Vedanta is just pointing out to day-to-day experience. Not it's not me. I'm teaching the Vedanta prakriya. Okay? To try to find out, try to tell you how our day-to-day life itself is a dream-like state. Vedanta is taking our own life example and telling us. So, if you say Miss Swapna is false because she is a mind she was in my mind she is a mental character then what you are experiencing now is it in the not in your mind where am I am here I am a thought in your mind actually without thought I am not there so I am also a thought in your mind I am also in your mind so in dream you saw a tiger that was a thought in the mind that's a thought tiger So what is the distinct difference? The dream state and waking state, Miss Jagrati and Miss Swapna, both are troubled lot. They have something to do and run around and survive in the world. Miss Sushupti is relaxed and peaceful. No trouble because there is nobody to trouble. Right? So in deep sleep, do you exist? Do you exist?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
You exist. Do you know you exist?